PA's going, you don't really hear the horn anymore, and they go really fast, but you're going to feel the room shake. So just understand, it's not an earthquake, and you're not in danger for your life. So it's just the Norfolk Southern. So, and they'll just go on through and do their thing, and we'll keep doing our thing. Also, this is a very appropriate time for me to say hello to you folks watching the live stream at EOP Live on YouTube. We are so happy to have you with us. You'll notice a blue box at the top of the chat box there. Now, that's the tip jar. And we're not going to be upset at all if y'all put a whole lot of money in that tip jar this evening. Anya and Finn will be very grateful. So please consider that. And remember, these people paid a whole lot of money to see this show, and you ain't paying nothing. So please consider tipping into that tip jar, and we'll be thanking you in advance for your generosity. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Now, I got to tell you something. This is going to be one of those shows that I really consider as authentic and real as anything I do. A lot of this music is going to sound like absolutely Virginia Appalachian music, and there's a reason for it, because Anya is from the Appalachians in Virginia. And so it just makes sense that that's what it would sound like. And she has this side guy, this Finn McGill guy. And I'm going to tell you right now, he ain't no side guy. He is a virtuoso. And he ain't no fiddle player. He is a master of his instrument. And I can't wait to hear them together as we have before. Again, I should say, because they have been here before. And it's so much an honor to have them back, because I love them and I love their craft and they're really good, and I know you're going to buy all their shit that's in the lobby before you leave, because they won't be upset at all if you do that. So please consider it and give a nice welcome to Anya Hinkle.
Gonna pick you up 2,000. great to be back here, and really big thanks to everybody that came out tonight. We've got two sets of music, and I'm getting ready to start thinking about a new album. This album, Eden in Her Borderlands, is just turning one this month, and you know, suddenly it's time for a new record, so I'm going to try some new songs out on y'all tonight, so please be kind. Let me know what you think, but for now, we're going to just do some old favorites as well, and this is for a woman called Zona Abston. It's called The Ballad of Zona Abston, and I heard from her family member that her husband, Cotton, passed away. She said, can I get a copy of this song sent to me? And it's just great because this is about real people, y'all. This is a true story. And I'm going to send this one out to Zona tonight. And a wife pays the way. down a company ain't ever worth a day. And I've wanted for daddy, and I've wanted for learning, I've wanted for some of God's good away. If there's anyone to know, there's more to life than a dollar bill, Lord, you know it's me. Am I deserving this cold hearted dream? About it when I wrote the set list, but on that song and this next one, about a couple of women that grew up without a lot of choices in this world, and you know, now they have even fewer. This next tune is about my neighbor. I think the story was she shot her husband once. He lived, but I think he deserved it. That's the story I heard. Thank you. case you're wondering who this handsome guy is over here, sawing on that little guitar, this is Andrew Finn McGill, and originally from Asheville, North Carolina, but he's traveled and made music all over the world. So proud to have him standing up here with me. And we're going to do... Well, thank you. And I'm going to do this song for the ladies in the audience. I was going through kind of a rough time. My band was breaking up and I didn't know what I was going to do. And this girlfriend called me. She said, I got a great bottle of wine. We're going to figure this out. And so I went over there and I laughed. I cried. And I was driving home. I was like, man, this is why women need wine. You know, I thought, wait, there's a song in this. And so anyways, I started thinking about all the reasons that, not so much the wine, but we just need each other to kind of laugh about all the crazy, silly, ridiculous, frustrating things there are in this world. And anyway, it's all good when we got each other. Thank you. the dam. And thanks so much for listening. And feel free to help me understand why I gotta over-explain just why my aim misses the mark about every time. Just trying to get myself back in line is why women need wine. Girlfriend of mine listened to the song. She's a wonderful artist. And I said, would you make a illustration that kind of illustrates the lyrics to the song? And so she did. And I had them printed on various items, including a tea towel. And a woman came up before the show. And she's like, I'll take five of those. She's like, I'm going to give them all my girlfriends from elementary school. So anyway, thank you for picking those up. And there's more of that stuff, but you know, it's just kind of a fun little, you know, fun little thing. And let's see, we're gonna do, we're gonna feature Finn on this, do a good old time fiddle tune called the Smith's Reel.
That's
right. So.
That's all there is to know. usually my mic is muted for a reason.
Yeah, you know, when you ride in the car with Finn, you're just, uh-huh. That's pretty much all you have to say the whole time.
So the way Anya gets back at me is by keeping my mic muted for the whole show. But anyway, here it is, Smith's Reel. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Thank you.
just want to say we really love this venue, and it's first class in every way. I mean, just the way that this is all laid out, the amazing volunteers, and the incredible staff they have. And if you go downstairs, it's just a first class experience for us as well. You know, we see a lot of different places on the road, and when you run into somebody that runs such a tight ship like these folks, it really makes our job so much easier. And so get on their mailing list, make sure you come back and support them. You know, they're doing a great job for their artists, and we're really grateful for that. So yeah, keep on coming back, not just for us, but for all the folks that play here. This last record I put out, I recorded over the pandemic, and I was hanging out with a friend of mine yesterday. He said, "I'm so tired of artists talking about their pandemic record. The music wasn't that good. They were just sitting at home, not talking to anybody." So I don't know if that's true or not, but here I am, another artist, saying, "Here's my pandemic record." And I thought there were some good songs on it. I hope you agree. But one song that meant a lot to me to write came as I was sitting, as I often do, on the floor early in the morning. And it's a meditation. I meant to write words, but none came. You know, there was just a point in the pandemic where what were you going to say, really? You know. This one's called Meditation Beyond the Shores of Darkness. Thank you. I was recently in Europe for a month. It was my second time in Europe, but the longest I had been there total. I went to the Netherlands, I went to Denmark, Sweden, and France. And one interesting experience I had when I was in Sweden was that our opening act was a man from the Ukraine. And they had just packed the whole family in the car, like three or four kids, a wife, a couple mothers, grandmas, you know, whatever. And they just drove to Sweden. They were just there. And I had written a song earlier this year, the day after Putin invaded. And when I was writing this song, I thought to myself, there's a bird here. And I discovered that the nightingale is the sacred bird of the Ukrainian people. It means fertility, love, hope, peace. And so this song's called The Nightingale, and I just, it meant a lot for me to be able to sing it for this family. I also put a bootleg version up on Bandcamp, and I was able to raise $2,000 to send to Doctors Without Borders to help with the refugee crisis. And so it felt good to be able to help in some small way. And also to bring this song to Europe, you know, it's a really different deal over there. People remember, you know, they remember the old wars.
Crossing hills, crossing bridges, under the gray, gray cloak of war, moving in, bearing down, yeah, it's taking control. There's a man, he's got steely eyes, got a steely hammer that he's slamming from the sky. He tells a tale, thin as a he's screaming from his easy chair.
All right, y'all, we're going to do one more tune. And then go hang out. Maybe get a beer or something. With Molly. She's at the bar. She's real nice. And when I got home, you know, I was happy to be home. But actually, you know what? I was really kind of thinking I was ready to go back out again. It's pretty exciting. And it's also nice to not think about things like dishes and laundry. I think I did my laundry once in a month. Yeah, there's a lot of other things that take precedence. But I was reminded of this song by one of my favorite musicians and the person that I fell in love with 16 years old when I was learning to play music. He's a Georgia musician. His name is Norman Blake. And he wrote this song called Orphan Annie. And anyway, just kind of resonated with me on coming back. Y'all, we'll see you in a second. Thank you.
Takes a killing, it will not take me. The fire that takes a killing will not take me. The fire that takes a killing won't take me. As my grandma told me, this asshole that I see.
and the rain that floods the valley, you will not drown me. The rain that floods the valley will not drown me. The rain that floods the valley, whoa, whoa, drown me. As my grandma told me, this high solo that I see. And the hawk that stoops a sparrow, it will not strike me. The hawk that stoops a sparrow will not strike me. The hawk that stoops a sparrow, whoa, whoa, strike me. As my grandma told me, this high solo that I see. And the dark before the dawn breaks, it will not bind me. The dark before the dawn breaks will not bind me. The dark before the dawn breaks, whoa, whoa, bind me. As my grandma told me, this high solo that I see. And the wind that shakes the valley will not shake me. The wind that shakes the valley, it will not shake me. The wind that shakes the valley, whoa, whoa, shake me. Yeah, my grandma told me, this high solo that I see. Hey, my grandma told me, this high solo that I see. Hey, my grandma told me, this no, that I see.
Thank you very much. Allie Russell, everybody.
McDowell and Brian Geiswacher. Michael Geiswacher, Timlin McDowell. Thank you, guys. Appreciate it. Thank you so much.
Hello. Anya graciously let me take this first one on my own, so I'm gonna do a solo for you. Well, calm down now, you haven't heard it yet. You might not like it. So I grew up playing fiddle music. However, in the last few years, I've really developed a love for, call it violin music. And I guess this really started in the pandemic. I've always loved the music of J.S. Bach, and in the during the pandemic, I was practicing Bach about every day. And but I definitely have sort of a fiddler's approach to it. So I was going to play you just a snippet of a little piece of music that I've been working on, and follow. And so the snippet is a little bit of feedback. Sorry. The snippet is part of the D minor partita, the partita in D minor, which is from the book, the J.S. Bach book of solo violin, partitas and sonatas. Amazing music. And I'll follow it with kind of my favorite tune at the moment. This is a tune that comes from the northwest of France, a region called Brittany. And it was written by Erwan Mangy, who is an amazing flute player. One of my favorite flute players, as a matter of fact. And so he wrote this waltz called Tempus Fugit. My Latin's a little bit... For the people that studied Latin out there, I apologize. But yes, Tempus Fugit, time flies.
All right.
Thank you.
Well, next we're going to go across the world to do a tune that I learned, actually. It's an American tune, but I learned this in Japan. And I'm going to sing it for you in both English and Japanese. It's called My Blue Heaven.
Instruments are not used to the air conditioning. Eddie was like, oh, I didn't think about that. I can't really hear your time. I know.
Next one is a brand new tune, and I have to blame it on Finn. We had a couple gigs together, and ended up in Raleigh, North Carolina, and we were at this Airbnb, and Finn looked under the bed, and there was like a bunch of trash, like a whole bunch of empty soda cans and like food and all kinds of stuff, and he's like, this place isn't clean, and then the night fell, and it's like, she's like, you know, the Roach Motel, you know. So then he left, you know, he left for the week, and I was there at the Roach Motel all week long just for various things I had to do. But anyway, he said, you can write a song about this. So I did.
As Anya likes to say, there's a song in that.
Yeah, it wasn't the happiest of times, but I tried to jump in with 2 feet. And so thanks to Finn, I was sitting there in the yard thinking that Elizabeth Cotton, who's a, you know, obviously kind of a hero of mine, heroine, she's a great fingerstyle blues guitar player. And she grew up right there. I was thinking she grew up here right in Chapel Hill, not far from where I was. And so I kind of wrote this song inspired by her. And if you've never heard Elizabeth Cotton, you probably know this song, Freight Train, Freight Train. Going so fast. Might hear a little bit of that in here. No, you you guys want a little more of that fiddle.
This next tune is it's a pretty common tune in old time and bluegrass. I first heard the great Virginia fiddle player Eddie Bond play this. It's Durang's Hornpipe.
July 4th weekend, and you know, it's like with July 4th, it's kind of like all the way up to this point, it feels like summer's going to last forever, you know what I mean? And then after this week, well, you realize, just like everything else, and it's not going to last forever, but let's enjoy it while we can, endless summer. This next tune is a song that I wrote with a composer called Akira Satake, a Japanese banjo player that lives in the Asheville area. And he had written this beautiful song called Swananoa and asked me to write lyrics for it. And so we came up with this tune. It's called The Hills of Swananoa. It's kind of about the Great Flood of 1916. And I was really proud that this song won runner-up in the International Acoustic Music Awards in their bluegrass and country category this year. And Akira and I have another song coming out, a really sweet song about his childhood coming out at the end of this month. So you can hear that, you know, just keep in touch. It'll be, if you're not on my mailing list, just sign up and I'll tell you about it. But thank you.
Quaker's balsam, twisted laurel hills. Not a body or soul forgive. The green, green grass and the fertile fields, deer and rabbit fade. Oh, with heaven on its mane. When a maiden of the mist took my hand and led me to the golden light. Pulled a plow straight in a lane. Hey, hey, walk me down, down to the valley below. Where the snow still falls in April and the mist don't leave till noon. In the hills is long. Just a sprite of the woods, just a spirit of the river running by. Oh, an elf playing under the trestle. A little baby girl, a baby born with dazzling water in her eyes. In the grotto of her daddy's hired to nestle. Hey, hey, walk me down, down to the valley below. Where the snow still falls in April and the mist don't leave till noon.
Try another new song on y'all. You ready?
Yeah.
I realized, you know, as artists, like, we're all about our egos or whatever, you know. We're all, like, thinking about, you know, it's hard to get out of your head or whatever, and I mean, you know, not really we're all about our egos, but it is. It's hard to get out of your head, and we think, like, oh, we just want to make this magnus opus, like this great work, and just drop it in your lap and have everybody go, like, oh, wow. But really, you know, we need you to, like, help us get this material out there and, like, try it out, see what works, see what doesn't. So, like, you know, we need to make mistakes and screw up. Like, you'd be able to say, like, oh, I heard her play that song for the first time. She really screwed it up, you know. Like, so this is fun, and it's part of the process. So I'm trying to get out there and do some of this new material. So thanks for being part of this whole process. It's fun. And this tune, you know, there's a lot to be grateful for, and there's a lot that goes through our heads at the same time. And I kind of, just this thing popped into my head. I thought, hallelujah, I'm doing all right. And that's, I think, as best as we can hope for most of the time. Thank you. And gonna leave you with one last song. And this is I'm sending this one special out to Eddie because, well, it's a train song. You know, when I was little, I grew up in southwestern Virginia, and my best friend from second grade is right here in the audience. Laura, she had a paper route. I used to go out with her, and it was hilly, but we rode our little Schwinn bikes all over. But later on, I used to like to go down to the New River, and there was a train that would go by, hauled coal, and our feet would get all black, and we'd get in trouble. I remember I drove my boyfriend's car in the river once on accident. I was just kind of learning how to drive. Obviously, needed some more practice. But anyway, thank you again for being here, and here we go.
Anya Hinkle.
Finn McGill.
Hi. You're too kind. I did get a request at the break that I wanted to honor. And it's not one that Finn and I have had rehearsed, so I think I'll just do this on my own. And this is not one that I ever play on my own, so we'll see how it goes. But this was a song that is on my last album, and it's called What's It Gonna Take? And the day after George Floyd was killed, I had a writing date with a buddy of mine, a neighbor, who's in a band called the Steep Canyon Rangers. He plays the banjo. And Graham Sharp, and he and I got together and looked at each other, what do you want to write about? And so anyway, this song kind of came out, and we kind of worked on it as the country kind of convulsed and all that we saw and felt, and put this song together called What's It Gonna Take? And when we went into the studio to record it, I had met a wonderful couple at the folk festival, Sacred Steel player, just straight out of the gospel church, and his wife, who's a fantastic gospel singer, and I asked Wendy and Deshaun if they would sing it with us, because somehow we just needed to join voices from the black community and the white community together to ask this question, what's it going to take? And, you know, it's just more of a question than an answer, for sure. Tell me what's it gonna take? Thank y'all. Have a wonderful night.